When I think of NASA, I think of rocket ships.
You know, when I think of NASA, I think of like spaceships and outer space.
I think of space travel. I think of the universe.
The space shuttle.
Hubble telescope.
Space exploration.
Over the last few years, I think NASA is more involved in just the total environment effort.
I had no clue NASA came out to New Orleans and did research about the wetlands.
I'm so glad. I mean, you guys have rockets. You can fix this, right? I hope you can. If you can land on the moon, you can fix the wetlands.
Here we go. New line 32032 loaded.
Power's up.
Copy that. PPA engage.
And release.
Line started. Copy. Line started.
I'm from southern Louisiana. This is a really unique place. I still have family and friends here, and I just want to keep it safe and protect what they have.
Right now, Sam, the PPA operator on the back, he's now coordinating with the radar operator, and they're flying the airplane. This particular mission, we're imaging kind of the wetlands and basically the New Orleans, Louisiana area.
UAVSAR has been flying over Louisiana and collecting data about 2 to 3 times a year since 2009. What we do is we send out pulses from the radar, and we track both when we receive the pulses and exactly where the antenna was when we received the pulse. And that way we can create synthetically a very long antenna with very high resolution on the ground.
PPA is platform precision autopilot system. What it does is goes through a tube with a very precise line. Flying over the same line over and over allows us to study the wetland over time.
By understanding how the deltas and everything work, we can potentially save many lives.
Wetlands are important for a few reasons. Probably the biggest reason that they're important in the state of Louisiana is that they help push back storm surge. And they provide a space between the land and the sea, and that helps keep the sea at bay, which helps keep flooding at bay.
Also for economic reasons, the Port of New Orleans is big business, and they have had to deal a lot with the wetlands losses affecting how goods and services are moved up and down the Mississippi River. It doesn't matter where you live in the United States, 40% of the seafood, it's all fished right here off the coast of southern Louisiana. Also, the oil infrastructure, especially the refining, is right here on the coast. So if you like to eat seafood and you drive a car, you are most likely, no matter where you live in the United States, affected by the wetlands loss that's happening to southern Louisiana right now.
This land loss is caused by a number of reasons, but some of the biggest ones are the channelization of the Mississippi River that prevents sediment from reaching the wetlands, the construction of a large number of canals, and subsidence. The land is sinking. UAVSAR provides the kind of broad-scale view of the coast that we need to understand how fast it's changing, how fast the land is sinking.
You see it in streets, which are in horrible condition. Those areas that are subsiding are going to be most vulnerable to sea level rise. They're going to be most vulnerable to erosion when the storms come in.
And that's 502, I'm showing the block now, so you're pretty much just going to be flying on your course now, correct?
502, we're going to do one more circuit here for timing, and then we'll be going inbound.
All right.
This particular study today, we're looking at delta formation for all the other problems Louisiana has. It also has these two very unique deltas that are actually growing. We can look at how natural deltas form so that we can understand more about sediment deposition and maybe try to reverse loss of sediments in many of the other deltas around the world. One thing we've seen recently is a lot of subsidence around the area. And often right next to the river or close to the levees. And whenever the ground subsides in an area, it actually brings the levees down also.
Line complete, PPA disengaged.
Copy, got it.
I hope to keep working on this for a long time. I think that we're collecting really great data. One thing that's happening is we're getting more and more people locally involved in this kind of science. And the more local people are involved, the more use it'll have.
The levee system goes with the wetlands. If we don't take care of the wetlands and start helping the wetlands come back, we're going to lose New Orleans as we see it today.
The practical thing that UAVSAR can help inspire is the state's coastal restoration plan. One of the big complications with the plan is that we don't know issues of subsidence very well to the kind of fine-scale degree that we need to plan restoration projects. And UAVSAR provides us with the kind of fine scale but broad scale measurements that we need to advance Louisiana's master plan for a sustainable coast.
People say this is the northernmost point in the Caribbean. I don't know why it was built here, but I'm thankful that it was. You know, we have hundreds of years of culture, and what I think is different about New Orleans is our culture is on the surface. It's not just a building, or it's not just a kind of food we eat, but it is everything, and it permeates our rhythm, our way of life, our way we talk. It hangs in the air, almost like this humidity that is so oppressive here. I want to do everything we can to protect our city so that we don't have another catastrophe, loss of life, loss of people, and loss of what I think is the greatest city in America.